Hi, welcome to a brand new video where I really wanted to show you some exciting updates from the Polycom site. We all know the traditional rooms, as you see here, with a Polycom mic on the table. You got your RP Touch, dual screen system, your director on top, your producer on top. This is all well known by the Polycom community and used a lot by our customers. Now, what Polycom is introducing as of today is we have now the option to use a trio only on the table in combination with the group series behind the screen. So we don't call it the group series anymore, we call it in that case the Visual Pro. The trio is in that case the codec. It does the speaker, the mic, it has the control function on the table for the user, and everything that you need on the table. You can of course hook up your extension mics to the trio and to use that, but you can see the group series now just like the Visual Plus, well-known box, and just doing the extension onto the screen paired over the network with the trio. You can do the same thing now with group series as Visual Pro. You just pair it over the network with the trio on the table, and trio becomes really your centralized hub on the table. You can do this with the 8500 and with the 8800. You can do it with both. But what I really like with the 8800 is that it has the proximity sensor. So as soon as you walk into the room, you turn on the light, the screen will wake up. So as soon as it notifies people in the room, it will call the people to the screen. And also the 8800 has the bass reflex port. It's a bigger audio range, all that things. But if you don't need that, you can also work with the 8500, no problem. Now, if you want to use this combination, there are some requirements, and this is what I wanted to walk you through. So how does the pairing looks like? What version do you need? What hardware version do you need, etc.? Now, let me show you. So first of all, you need to check if your group series, which can, by the way, be a 310 or a group 500, it needs to be hardware revision 20. So please look on the back of your unit and make sure you have at least HEY-V20. It's a small sticker on the back of the unit to check that. Now the other way to check that is the web UI. So let me show you. So here you see in the web UI, look under system, you see there on the top hardware version 20. So make sure you are on at least on that hardware version or higher. If you are lower, you need to do a trade-in or something. But you need to have, you want to hook up a trio, a centralized device on the table onto the Visual Pro. You need to make sure you have this hardware version. Otherwise, the connection between trio and group series is impossible. You cannot pair them. Now, the other thing is, as a software version, make sure you are at minimum with the group series Visual Pro on 6110. So if you want to make your group series a Visual Pro, make sure you are on that version. Now, if you want to make your group series a Visual Pro, you go to System Settings, you go to a new option, which is available now here in the group series, System Mode. You see the default system mode is group series mode. And now the only thing is you need to put it into Polycom Trio mode, save and restart, and your system will be able to pair with a trio. But be aware, as soon as you put the group series here in the trio mode, so it will become a Visual Pro, your HEY-V20 will not be available, like serial and some other pieces. So please look in the documentation and release notes if that works for your specific environment. Now, a quick review on the options available for the Visual Plus and the Visual Pro, just to give you a good overview of what the options are. Now, as you can see, on the left side we got the Visual Plus, on the right side the Visual Pro. And the Visual Pro is, by the way, available as Visual Pro on the market. So if you really don't need group series functionality, like H323 and all those things, you can get the Visual Pro. That is possible. Now, on the backside, let me review that. If you know the group series, people will probably know. As you can see, Visual Plus has the HDMI, the screen output, has the mini jack output to a soundbar. You have your USB connected devices like the Eagle Eye USB or the Eagle Eye Mini. These options are available for the Visual Plus. I think that's very important. And of course, you got here your pairing, your network pairing with the Trio over the network with your PoE. Now, if you look at the Visual Pro, which of course can be a 310 or a 500, but they both look the same. Now, what is very important, you don't need any option license with the Visual Pro if you put the group series in Visual Pro mode. We know from the group series side, you usually have license for dual screen, 1080p, a Microsoft license. These licenses are not needed when you use a group series in the Visual Pro modus. I think that is very important. This is because the Visual Pro is pure a hardware extension to the Trio, which is the centralized device on the table in the room. So here you have all the options available, which were available from the group series side, are available here as the Visual Pro. So you got here your camera connector, which can be a producer, can be Eagle Eye Director, can be an Eagle Eye 4, 4x zoom, 12x zoom, acoustic camera. These are all still available to connect. On this side, we have the inputs, of course, the HDMI input. This can be used in combination with the Pano, for example, if you want to do the wireless sharing. And what is important is everything that comes here in through this HDMI port. So let's say you're using a Pano and you're sharing some audio. This will also go into the Skype for Business meeting. I think that is very important to know. So if you use your laptop on the table, you got your HDMI cable on the table, that gives audio, you're sharing maybe a video or anything like that, which has audio, the Visual Pro, and also Group Series, by the way, will share this audio in the Skype for Business meeting. So we are able to add the audio, the Visual Pro Group Series, is able to add this audio in the Skype meeting. I think this is really a great benefit of the combination that you have here. We don't use the mini jack input at the moment. What is possible to use is the C-Link, for example, here. That is for the digital mics, which can be ceiling mics, for example. So let's say you have the option and the flexibility to use ceiling mics. There's a maximum of 2 ceiling mics which you can connect here up to the Visual Pro. Here you have the connectivity, a mini jack output. This is the audio feedback for the, for example, if you use an Eagle Eye Director 2, which need to do the acoustic filtering from the remote party, the acoustic echo cancellation. This will be used to inject the audio output to the Eagle Eye Director 2, for example. So you can still use all those options. Here is screen 1, screen 2. As I said, don't need any license. It's really just a matter of putting the system in Visual Pro mode and pair it up to the Trio, as I will show you, and you got all that functionality available. Here you see two USB ports, which are, I think for software updates still used, but don't hook up here, for example, the Eagle Eye Mini or the Eagle Eye USB. That doesn't work in the Visual Pro. You really need to use the camera input made for the Visual Pro to make that possible. Serial is not used at the moment for the Visual Pro, maybe in the future. And of course, Ethernet and the power. So hopefully, this gave you a good overview the difference between the Visual Plus and the Visual Pro. If you got any questions, please submit also on the video so I can help you with that. Now let me show you the pairing, because I think that is also just good to see how that works. Now, if you put a Group Series 310 or 500 into the Trio mode, you will see the following on the screen. Here you go. This is the Group Series in Visual Pro modus. Exactly the same as you see here as the Visual Plus when you hook it up. Make sure that the Trio and Visual Pro, like Visual Plus, is in the same network, and so they're able to pair with each other. Now, on the Trio side, you go under the advanced settings and use your default password from the Trio or something you configured. You go under advanced settings, you go to the network devices, and as you can see, you see here the Group Series Visual Pro popping up as not connected. So you click on that, and here you go. You see the options just like the Visual Plus, and you say pair. So here you got it on the screen. So as soon as I say pair this device, and I say complete, and boom, what do you see? It's now all connected. You see the video popping up. And as you see also, I hooked up here the producer on top of the screen with the Eagle Eye 12 times zoom. So can you really mix and match with the Visual Pro and with the Trio on the table, like everything you see here. And also what I hooked up is here, you see the HDMI cable. So if this is really key for you and you have the Trio on the table and you want to have the HDMI cable on the table, that is possible now by using the Trio 8800 in combination with Visual Pro, single screen or dual screen. That's all possible. Soundbar underneath, you can also use that with the audio output. So I guess it's all possible as a setup. Now, just to show you quickly, if you want to share, grab the HDMI cable, just put it here in the side of the laptop, and it's really just a matter of show and present here, show from my slide here, and here you go, you got your PowerPoint here presented on the screen. I think that's very powerful. So now you have your Trio as your centralized hub on the table, and you can build everything around it. So you can use the HDMI input for your laptop as I do now, or for the Pano, or for like anything that you have. And it will be shared in a meeting, which I will show you. Make sure you got minimum hardware revision 20. So don't use any other hardware revision. You won't see the option to pair it. So make sure you are on hardware revision 20 and you will get the pairing option. Now, what is, I think, is available is and what is important is the versions. So here you see the latest, the 6110 for the Group Series or Visual Pro, And for the trio side, make sure you are on 572AB. I guess these are very important. And then you can use all the features that are available. So you can use the trio, SD mic and the speaker, one device on the table. But if you want, you can also still use the table mic from the group series. So you combine that with ceiling mics and with table mics. And I guess there's a lot of integration options to discuss with your partner, and a lot of options available. HDMI, audio, or through the soundbar, these are all available. Now, as a demonstration, I can show you, for example, the sharing from both directions, which I think is a great feature for the Visio Pro, if you are in a Skype for Business meeting. So let's say I want to do it from the Skype for Business side. You go to Share Desktop. I will open up my presentation and do it full screen. And boom, as you can see, VBSS content directly into the meeting. For VBSS, by the way, make sure you're all on the latest Skype for Business client. But I think that's very powerful. You will have send and receive natively in the Visio Pro, just like you had with the group series. Give you 30 frames per second when you share content, and it will also give you a much better experience, setup or mobile networks or anything. It's much more robust and a better frame rate than the RDP protocol. Now, to show you sharing content from Visio Pro side, I hooked up a panel onto the HDMI input of the Visio Pro. And to show you that the content will come here in my Skype for Business meeting. So now it's turned off. And now let me share the content from the Visio Pro side. And as you can see, you're seeing now the panel hooked up on the HDMI input into the Skype for Business meeting. And what is important, this includes the audio. So this is very important. So we include the audio coming from the panel or a laptop, sharing maybe a video. That audio is included now into the Skype for Business meeting. Now, all the other good stuff, what we see used a lot in the market today, as the click to join functionality is of course all available. With the Visio Pro, you can create custom backgrounds, you can show multiple meetings, but you can also customize that if you want to only show one. Customized background, logos, and of course here on the Trio, you see here the easy join experience. So before the meeting, you will be able to start the meeting. I think that is all very powerful. And one last thing to mention is, of course, this combination with the Visio Pro and the Trio can all be managed through Resource Manager or the PDMS, Polycom Cloud Management Service. So Polycom has now different options available. I will probably be a next video which I'll create for you. But you can manage all those devices to the cloud. Monitor, software upgrades, customizing home screen of the Visio Pro here, the background, and of course the Trio, customizing the icons and everything. It's all available. And also, don't forget all the functions. So we lose H323 with the Visio Pro, but with the Trio, we got the SIP hybrid option. So don't forget, you get here Skype for Business connected. You can call up to a BlueJeans meeting. So you can just click here, for example, on BlueJeans, which will dial the system into the IVR. And then you can punch a meeting room number, as you can see right here, dialing into the BlueJeans IVR, punching your meeting room number. But also, if you got real presence on premise, so let's say you have a VMR, Polycom Clarity or Polycom Infrastructure on-prem. You can also click here on Real Presence, dial a meeting room number and dial. And here you're dialing now into Polycom RMX. So it's very flexible. You have all the flexibility available for the system. You can create multiple IVRs. Here you got, for example, an IVR to Zoom meeting. As you can see here, you just punch in your meeting ID and you can go into a Zoom meeting. And I think that is all very powerful with the Trio at the moment. All these options, so I now show you here, click to join a Skype for Business meeting, but the Trio can also do click to join for BlueJeans, click to join for Zoom, Fidexio, click to join for Fidexio. We have all those options available. So don't forget that. That's really from the endpoint side, you can integrate this with all different platforms.